Hey guys, this is a Crafty Dad here, and I'm going to show you guys a video on making a beanie cap. So what I'm going to first do is show you my Centro 40 needle circular knitting machine. So it is set up right here and it is just about ready to go. All I need to do is reach over here and get some yarn here. And so the yarn that I'm going to be using today is going to be Wool Ease. It's going to be the Lion's brand. So it is going to be 80% acrylic and 20% wool. And this is a medium four, so we'll go ahead and take this out and then push it down, try to scrunch it up a little bit, get it going, and then we will go ahead and find the end and we will start getting our piece working. Let's see where it's at. So maybe here. Yep, I was right. Have it right here. So go and take a long piece, throw it in there, and we're already set up, looks like, right here. See, I couldn't move it, I'm trying to figure out why, because it was in the flat knitting mode, so I will flip the switch up. Now it is in circular mode, I can move it both ways. The reason why you can move it both ways, but if you are near the first tooth, the star tooth, black one, it stops there, so it isn't going to let you. So here we go, we'll go ahead and cast on, so we'll go in and out, all the way through. So it'll probably look like I'm going fast, because I will probably fast forward this just a little bit. For me, so it will fit my size. So right here, you gotta make sure that you put it down. So right now, it looks like it's in, but it's actually not. So I need to actually pull it down through this little slit here, so you go through the feeder, but it that has to go through the slit as well. So now what my main focus is make sure that I pull off the yarn and not let my wool yarn ball go flying around here. So I'll hold down, we'll go ahead and start turning this one out and see how our project turns out. I think it'll be a good little project here. I'm excited to get this black beanie. Have a little bit of wool in it to keep it a little bit warmer. It's been a little bit cold out here lately, and yeah, I definitely want to stay warm, and this is definitely the way to do it, to use that wool, because I mean, wool has a lot of good properties to it compared to just plain acrylic. So plain acrylic isn't going to have that wicking ability that this wool has, so definitely will use that. But here we go, looks like we are on about four rows. I don't have a row counter yet. I'm trying to figure that one out. I have a way of doing it, but don't have it with me. So we'll figure that out later and it will go. So right now I'm on five and I will go ahead and fast forward through this and you guys will see it, see the thread coming down. So go through. One thing that I am noticing here is that I know when I need to go ahead and pull out my yarn because this tension starts to lift up. So even though I'm looking straight down, I'm not looking back at the yarn, I really don't need to, because as soon as this thing starts pulling up, and you'll go ahead and see it, I'll twist the machine here so you guys can check it out. Once this tensioner lifts up a little bit, I know that I have to go and fix my yarn and pull out a new bunch of my threads so that I could keep on moving. So again, I'll go ahead and fast forward through now that I told you that, and I'll keep on going and get it down. That is basically it. So now I am done with the project here. It looks good. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and cut it here. Go ahead and snip this here. And I will grab a hook and a needle. And I will start taking it off. So first thing that I do, tip for you guys, is I always turn the machine. That way what happens is you're already on the hooks where it is already unhooked. So the hooks are already down and you can go ahead and pull it off that way instead of having to work from the side. Makes it a little bit easier from what I found. The other thing I do is I always tie a knot on here, a double knot, to make sure that it's set. Otherwise, it will come out. And you don't want that to happen and you can make it run. So. Got those two, so where did I pull my string out at? Right there. So we'll be hooked that one. And then we'll get hooked, and then I will be pulling the rest of them from there. So this one is the one that it is on, and I will pull the next one over. So it'll be this one here. Hook it, throw it through, pull it out. Hook it, lift it up. Put it through, put a string over it, and pull it out. Hook it, pull it up, string through, put it over, and pull it out. Very simple, not too hard. Just got to be careful to make sure that you hook it first. You can use one of the needles that actually has a hook on it, but what I have found is that I'm not that good. Sometimes I will accidentally grab the wrong section of it, or I'll grab halfway through the yarn and then I have to fix it, and I find it a lot easier if I can just grab it with a hook like this first. That way if I don't grab it, then I could always just let it go, or I could use this one to help myself out, and I can have two needles to be able to help myself instead of getting stuck and not having any help and trying to use my fingers real quick. I already have the tool in hand, it's ready to go. Then see if I actually start going fast, quit talking, start working, and and see how much faster I can do this. Now I will fast forward through it. You don't have to see it, and you will see that it can go pretty quick. Just now I will pop these up. Throw your string over in case it doesn't. You tie a knot right there, and then you won't be able to pull it through. It won't be loose, you'll be able to pull it through. So unless you've pulled it tight already, you have that knot there, and it won't let you cinch it. Please make sure to subscribe to my channel, because it is just getting off the ground, but definitely have a lot of cool things in there for you guys. You guys will be able to check out, and then you can always leave me some comments below and let me know what type of videos you guys want to see, and I can go to work on those as well. Pretty soon I'll be putting together a flat panel and trying to figure out how I'm making a blanket. So that will be in the future, not right now, but hey, soon enough, I tell you. All it takes is time. One of the next things I really want to do with this machine, seeing that it's a circular knitting machine, but it has the capability of doing flat panel work, so figured, why not? You saw my string was getting short, I just had to pull it a little bit, and it gets that slack, and then it go ahead and lengthens up. So I'll go ahead and finish this off. Check it out, the center of 40 needle, circular knitting machine. So now all I need to do here is go ahead and seal off the top and seal off the bottom. So we'll go ahead and do that really fast. So check it out. And I'll go ahead and put some type of maybe I'll put a pom-pom on there, but since it's for me, I probably won't. I'll probably just keep it like this. Seal it on top. A little tight. So I'll go ahead and lift this up. This place is so good. Nice and sealed. All the goal is here is to seal this top up. Tie it. Nice and tie knots around and make sure. Put my hand through. See how it comes down. And right back up there as I tie some knots. This one I probably won't put any type of faux fur, pom-pom, or any other pom-pom on it. And this one is basically sealed right there. I'll go ahead and throw this right back through. I'll tie a knot off from the inside as well. So throw it through, pull it in, pull this inside out. Throw it through, pull it out. Thank you. side here, so I will actually cut it down. But as they say, better to have too much than too little, because what happens when you have too little? Can't finish your project. Project gets undone. Got to go and tie another piece of string to another piece of yarn, and you know, sometimes that can cause an issue. Yeah. More than likely, you'd be able to fix it and hide it, and no one would know, but you would always know. Too many on this one, because when I pull through to the other side, I'll be sewing it into that one anyway. So that's a cool. Main goal is to make this nice and tight. So one more, we should be good. Make sure we open it up when we're doing it. Okay, so that's tied now. So now what I need to do, push this through into the next. Take my needle, run it in through, pull it all down, as far as it can go, pushing it in, using my hand to do that. Just throw this one right through the top of the side. Coming right through there. Here. I don't need to do the other one with a bunch of knots, because this one will be sealing itself. Then right now I'm pulling my needle and making a knot on the inside. Get myself a knot there, and I'll do it one more time. So I'm going up and through, and back down, my hand is healing it. I'm going to go in and out of it, I'm pulling straight through. Tying a knot. There we go. Tied that knot in there. Now I'm gonna go ahead and pull this out. Tie one more knot here, and that will be about done. Just needle around. Little straight thread here. There we go. This is time not gonna go all the way through. I'm gonna stick it in here. Tie the knot. And I will cut this here. Needle, I will thread it through and I will push it through the project. And when I push it through the project, this string, this yarn will be gone in the between area. So now it is off and I should be able to pull my needle out and have my project here. So here is a beanie cap right here. Nice, but not too big. It'll probably fit nice and snug. So I was looking for a nice little beanie, and as you can see, got it done in about 30 minutes or less. So, there you go. Thank you guys for watching. This is Crafty Dad, and please subscribe to the videos.